Wisdom, the final frontier to true knowledge. Welcome to Wisdom Trek, where our mission is to create a legacy of wisdom, to seek out discernment and insights, to boldly grow where few have chosen to grow before. Hello, my friend. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, your captain on our journey to increase wisdom and create a living legacy. Thank you for joining us today as we explore our second millennium of podcast. This is day 1034 of our trek, and it is time for Meditation Monday. Taking time to relax, refocus, and reprioritize our lives is crucial in order to create a living legacy. For you, it may be a time alone for quiet reflection. You may utilize structured meditation practices. In my life, meditation includes reading and reflecting on God's Word and in prayer. It is the time to renew my mind, refocus on what is most important, and making sure that I am nurturing my soul, mind, and body. As you come along with me on our trek each Meditation Monday, it is my hope and prayer that you too will experience a time of reflection and renewing of your mind. As we have just begun a new year, what do you need in order to make it a good and godly year? In our Meditation Monday today, I want us to reflect on fate versus free will. In Paul's letter to his protege Timothy, in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 6, he instructs him to, "This is why I remind you to fan into flame the spiritual gift God gave to you when I laid my hands on you." Timothy was divinely given spiritual gifts to assist in the building of God's kingdom, but it was up to him to do something with those gifts. Paul encourages him to turn up the heat and do something with the spiritual gifts that were provided. A good explanation for the difference between fate and free will is, fate is the hand that you are dealt with in life. Free will is what you do with that hand. We cannot choose to whom, when, or where we are born. That is determined only by God. While we are not responsible for, nor did we have any choice over what gifts and abilities we were born with, we are completely responsible for what we do about discovering and developing the gifts and the talents, and also how we use them. We are responsible for maximizing our God-given resources. Furthermore, regardless of your background, which I acknowledge has a profound effect on us, with God's help and the support of encouraging friends, we can refuse to allow our predetermined past to determine our future. We can overcome much of our past, develop our talents, learn new skills, or upgrade the skills that we already have. And we can become the person God wants us to be and do what we believe He wants us to do with our lives. We are without excuse, as we are encouraged in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10. "For we are God's masterpiece. He created us anew in Christ Jesus so that we can do the good things He planned for us long ago." God did plan our lives long ago. It all boils down to the choice of what we do with those plans. Either by conscious choice or by default, we all choose what we want to become and do what we choose to do. As another person has said, every single person is self-made, even if it's the successful ones that are the only ones who will admit it. And that's a wrap for today's meditation. Next week, we will continue in our trek on Meditation Monday as we take time to reflect on those most important areas of creating our living legacy. On tomorrow's trek, we will explore another wisdom quote. This 3-minute wisdom supplement will assist you on becoming healthy, wealthy, and wise each day. And thank you so much for allowing me to join you on this trek that we call life. Encourage your friends and family to join us, and then come along with us tomorrow for another day of Wisdom Trek, creating a legacy. If you'd like to listen to In the Past 1033 Daily Treks or read the daily journals, they are all available at wisdom-trek.com. And I encourage you to subscribe to Wisdom Trek on your favorite podcast player so that each day will be downloaded to you automatically. And thank you so much for allowing me to be your guide, your mentor, but most importantly, I am your friend as I serve you through the Wisdom Trek podcast and journal each day. And as we take this trek of life together, let us always live abundantly, love unconditionally, listen intentionally, learn continuously, lend to others generously, lead with integrity, and then leave a living legacy each day. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, reminding you to keep moving forward. Enjoy your journey. and then create a great day every day. See you tomorrow.